together. What it was a couple of Katanning area schools that merged together and formed a Quad A school. So that's where Newcastle is tonight. Elwood City will be down in Natrona Heights. They'll be playing Highlands High School tonight. And Union will be at Rochester. And Rochester being the favorite in the Division Tri-County North this year. So Union will be taking on a tough Rochester team. Monaca will be at Laurel. Aliquippa at Mohawk. And then Neshanic at Farrell. And what an interesting game that should be.
Oh, my. Yeah, the Neshanic Lancers have been having their difficulties. Well, of course, Farrell is ranked right behind Rochester as a shot for the Tri-County League. However, upsets are always possible.
Exactly.
Everybody remembers the Laurel-Farrell game in the playoffs when everybody expected Farrell to just run over Laurel like they did in the regular season to find that they lose in the playoffs. So you never know until it's over. Wilmington wins the toss, and they will be receiving. We're about ready for the kickoff tonight, Steve. Here at Wilmington Area High School, I'm Dave Barner along with Steve Chenevy. The Wilmington Greyhounds in their dark blue tops, blue helmets, and white trousers. And they'll be receiving the opening kickoff, and hopefully for both teams, we'll see some good offense. No injuries tonight. Speaking of injuries, it's good to see, Steve, that the Cornell player continues to improve, and we're glad to see that. And that the injuries nationwide are very small, it appears, according to the head trainer at Westminster College.
That is quite surprising, but it's one of those things where when you hear something like that, especially this close to home, that it just seems to be so much of a bigger deal, and it sounds a lot more dangerous, but if you go by the statistics, then an injury like that is quite rare. Hopefully we won't have to see anything else like that this season.
I want to give credit to the Wilmington Area Volunteer Ambulance here covering the game tonight, as they do all the Wilmington High School games. It's good to have that type of support standing by. And of course, in the Newcastle area, a lot of the paid ambulance services standing by at those games, just in case they are needed. Also a doctor on the sideline. We are ready for the kickoff now. By the way, before the game started, I was watching Adam Clapper, the Wilmington place kicker, and he was kicking them 30 yards from each hash mark tonight, so it'll be interesting to see if that happens. The kickoff is underway. It's going to be picked up by, it's going to be picked up now by Heath Margesso, it appears. No, picking it up, Sean McConaughey. Sean McConaughey will carry to the 25-yard line. Couldn't quite hold on to the ball, had a little trouble containing it, but had good protection, so was able to get some run back to the 25-yard line.
Well, it's a little cold out tonight. You're going to see a few numbed fingertips. Shouldn't have any impact yet, but as this game dwindles down, we will drop probably another 10 degrees in temperature. Could be by the time that the game is over. McConaughey picked the ball back up, and he got Wilmington back to average field position. The ball right around on the 25-yard line as Damon Hart gets set to run this offense for the Wilmington Greyhounds.
Damon Hart is the quarterback. There's split out to the right side and the left. He's back to pass on the first play. It sails over the hands of the intended receiver, Jens Jorgensen, standing about 6 yards downfield at the 31-yard line. So it's going to be second and 10 coming up for the Greyhounds from their own 25-yard line. Just underway, a bit delayed start here tonight at Wilmington Area High School.
Well, Damon Hart just missed it when he threw that ball because Jens Jorgensen was wide open. The Shenango defender had fallen on the play, and Jorgensen wide open, but the pass sailed about 5 yards over his head, and it was just a quick screen pass.
And now it's the I formation with the wing back out to the right side, and the handoff will be to McConaughey, who will try to bust ahead for a couple yards and will get, it appears to be, about 4 on the play. So it's going to be 3rd down and 6 coming up, and that will be from the Wilmington 28-yard line.
One of the things in watching before the game that Hart's been doing is he's been working on his handoffs a lot, and especially on a reverse handoff, and really trying to conceal that ball and try to trick the defense. And that time he just didn't get away with it, as McConaughey only got about 3 yards through the hole.
Now the wing T formation. The handoff will be to Smargesso, who tries the right side. Smargesso twists and turns. He's going to be very close to the first down, up at the 35-yard line. The ball is laying right on the 35 right now, and that's where the yard marker is. We'll wait for the official signal.
Well, one of the things about Smargesso, of course, is the strength of his legs. And if he is watching again in the pregame drills, when the running backs run a a clip drill and then try to power themselves through. Smart Gesso was just had no mercy even on his own players as he was running through his own players. So they're going to mark the ball. It looks like he's going to be just a little bit shy of the first down.
So it's going to be fourth down. Now they're going to take an official timeout. I don't know if it'll be a measurement or not. The ball originally was laying on the 35-yard line. That would have been a first down, but now the marking of the ball moves the ball back about a half yard. It appears to be short from our viewpoint, but the sticks are being pulled out. It is short. They do have to get to the 35. It will be fourth down at about a foot to go for the first down. Wilmington will be kicking for the first time tonight.
Well, that's not the kind of drive that Wilmington wanted to start the game with, or any team wants to start the game with for that matter, but I think Wilmington was looking to get something going tonight. If we do see that offensive matchup, and the team that gets on the board first is the one that has something to hold with. Wilmington doesn't pick up the first down, and Smart Gesso will be punting the ball.
And he does get a good boot. Chris Johnson will be back. Pick it up at the 35. He'll have trouble holding the ball, too. Now he picks it up, cuts to the right side of the field, fights ahead for about 3 yards to the 38-yard line. As both the opening kickoff and the punt here with some difficulty holding onto the ball tonight. So Shenango's in a little bit better field position than Wilmington, though, as they'll be starting on their own 39-yard line. Wilmington back at the 25. So it'll be first and 10 for Shenango on their first offensive series here at Wilmington Area High School.
It's our first chance to see the Shenango offense this season and see what they can do. As we said before, quarterback William DeCarbo has 6 touchdowns to his credit so far this year, 1 running and 5 through the air. And Alex Keddy, a tough running back as well.
And the handoff is for a big gain up across the 50 into Wilmington Greyhound territory. Alex Keddy gets the first call from William DeCarbo and bowls for the first down into Wilmington Greyhound territory at the Wilmington 42.
Wilmington defense is not going to be happy with that. When you see your first play, Shenango's first play picks up about 20 yards. However, for Shenango, that's just a huge lift to them. They're now sitting on about the 42-yard line. And they're looking to get the momentum swinging their way early in this ball game. Still 9 minutes to go in the first quarter.
A wing tee for the Shenango Wildcats is two. DeCarbo right in front of us in the press box. The handoff will again be to Alex Keddy, and he gets a good four yards on the play down to the Wilmington 38-yard line this time.
Keddy, 6'1", 175 pounds. Tough to bring down. A host of Greyhounds trying to bring it down on that play. Keddy picks up about 3 yards on the play. Call it second down and 7, but he moves the ball up just about to the 38-yard line.
So far, Shenango only 2 plays. They got the ball on their own 38 after the punt, and they've been moving the ball on the ground. The handoff again will be to Keddy, and Keddy will bust through for a couple more yards. Now the Wilmington Greyhounds think they've recovered. They do. They have the ball. The football is turned over to the Greyhounds, and so that'll stop the Wildcat drive, and the Greyhounds will take it right back, and that'll change the momentum right away, Steve. It's going to be first and 10 for the Greyhounds on their own 34-yard line.
That's a big play for the Wilmington Greyhounds, and really, really quick hit for the Wilmington Greyhounds. I'm looking to see, I believe it was Randy Young who put the hit on Keddy that time, and Keddy looked like he had the hole, and then Young just snapped him straight back, and the ball popped loose. Wilmington right in their position to recover.
Double wings for the Greyhounds. The handoff will be to Heath Smargesso, who will carry the ball to the 40-yard line, and he'll get a good 6-yard play on that. So it's going to be second down and 4 for the Greyhounds from their own 40-yard line.
Yeah, we're just about 4 and a half minutes into this ball game, and as Shenango is with Shenango fumbling the ball, there is the first official turnover of the game. But we've seen 2 kicks so far in the game, and neither kick return has been handled well either. So what Coach Sabetta was saying before about the team with the least turnovers winning the game could loom big in this situation.
Damon Hart, the quarterback for the Greyhounds, he's back to pass. He airs it out, it falls incomplete. It was intended for Chad Morris. He was down at the 50-yard line, but it sails over his head out of bounds, so it's going to be a 3rd down and 4 coming up for the Greyhounds. Make it 3rd down and 4 from the 40. They'll have to get out to the 44-yard line in their own end of the field.
Well, Hart had Jim Valenti breathing down his neck that play, and I believe he heard a few footsteps because Hart's pass wasn't anywhere close to his intended receiver. Valenti there to put a pretty good stick on Hart right after he let go of the ball. Pass will go incomplete. We will see a 3rd down and 4. The ball sitting right exactly on the 40-yard line.
It's the wing tee. The wing's off to the right side. Split end off to the left side. Hand off to Smart Gesso. He hits the right side of the line. He's going to be real near the first down yardage. He's up at the 44. Let's see where they place the ball.
Well, once again, we'll have to wait for the spot, and they'll probably bring out the chains once again to measure this one. Wilmington, their first two drives so far, close, but not close enough yet. We'll have to wait to see how they measure this as the officials call a timeout.
From this angle, it looks a bit short. The ball laying at about the 43.5. They have to get to the 44-yard line. That's where the stick was on the marker, but now we'll have the official measurement, and this is the eye that counts right here, Steve.
Oh, it certainly does, and as they stretch the chains out, it looks like they're going to give it to him by the nose of the football. First down for Wilmington, and Heath Margesso kind of stretched that ball out a little bit when he landed, and it looks like that made all the difference.
And so the Wilmington Greyhounds get their first down of the evening at the 44-yard line, moving the ball. Heath Margesso will head out here as a flanker to the near side. Split end out to the right side, wing back on the right side. The handoff is for a little gain, getting the ball with Steve McConaughey. He gets up to about the 47-yard line for a gain of 2. We'll give him 3 on the play now. It's going to be second down and 7.
Oh, Sean McConaughey trying to bust right through and drag a people with him, trying to create his own hole because there wasn't one for him. Only picks up a couple yards. It'll be second down and 8. Wilmington moving the ball slowly. Currently the ball is sitting right on the 47-yard line. Shenango defense holding up pretty well so far.
Identical formation. This time the handoff to McConaughey. He has the first down into the Shenango Wildcat territory in the Shenango 44. It'll be first and 10 for the Wilmington Greyhounds in the Wildcat territory.
Actually, that was sophomore Kyle Freeman that broke through that time. So the sophomore picks up about 12 yards on his own. The ball is going to be all the way down to between we'll call it the 43.5 yard line, if you want to go into details. But a good pickup by the sophomore Kyle Friedman, 6 foot, 180 pounds.
Double wing formation right now for the Greyhounds. Smargesso from the left wing gets the handoff. Smargesso drives the right side, gets little gain that time, maybe a yard or two, to the 43-yard line of the Wildcats.
Oh, there's going to be a flag on the play. Flag was thrown just as the play was ending.
It's going to be a holding call against the Wilmington Greyhounds. And that'll be a costly penalty as the Greyhounds have just moved into Wilmington territory.
Well, it's going to push them back. It's going to push the Wilmington Greyhounds back, a little bit of a setback. The holding call, not really near where the ball was and where the action was, but a holding penalty is one of the most frequent and one of the costliest penalties. It's what's going to stall just about any drive. So Wilmington's, the ball will be moved all the way back to the 47-yard line, excuse me. It'll be first down and 20 for the Wilmington Greyhounds.
They'll have to get down to the Shenango 22. They're in their own territory now. Damon Hart will be the quarterback. Coming out wide, Jens Jorgensen. And behind Damon Hart, the double wing formation. Smargesso in motion. Now switched up to the T formation. The handoff will be to Smargesso. There's a flag on the play thrown in the backfield. He'll get out to the 44-yard line. It's going to be only a gain of 3 or 4. It's going to be an illegal shift against the Wilmington Greyhounds.
And Wilmington's headed in the wrong direction right now, as that's going to march him back a few more yards. Not what Wilmington wanted to see after just getting the holding call. Now getting another penalty on the Wilmington offense.
This would be a 5-yard penalty if it's assessed. Illegal shift against the Wilmington Greyhounds. It is declined. They'll take the down instead since there was little gain on the play. They only gained 2 or 3 on the play. Now it's going to be second down and we'll say 17-yard line. 17 yards from the Wilmington 49.
Well, Wilmington running into their first trouble of the real serious trouble of the game. They had the one big pickup on the run by Kyle Freeman, and then now penalties have been haunting them. Got about 18 yards to go. They have to get down to the Shenango 34-yard line to pick up the first down, and the ball currently on the Wilmington 49-yard line.
Now it's the I formation. There's a wing back out on the left side and the split end out on the left side as well. Damon Hart will hand to the tailback. Heath Margesso, who spins and turns. He gets a couple yards on the play, but there's still going to be a third down at about 11 or 12 for the Greyhounds as they move back into Shenango territory on the 46-yard line.
Well, Wilmington on second down only sent one receiver deep, and that was Jens Jorgensen. Everybody else stayed in, and you could almost tell the run was coming. And it doesn't seem like the play, the ultimate play from that situation was such a large gainer. And Smart Jessup, as we've said, has been known to break the big play, but he's really been struggling the last couple games. 2 weeks ago, when we saw them play, Smart Jessup, of course, was our McDonald's MVP for the game with a good all-around performance. But his running game has suffered a little bit here tonight and last week as well.
Single back in the backfield, wing back out to the right side. Damon Hart will be back to pass. Damon Hart in trouble. He has to roll to the right. He's still in trouble. He's going to be sacked for a loss. It's going to be fourth down coming up for the Greyhounds on their own 50.
Well, Damon Hart, I think, just looked up, saw he had nowhere to go, and tried to run the ball immediately. As soon as he tried, broke out of the pocket, he just ran to his right side, and it looked like he would have had time to look downfield and try to pick somebody up, but Hart just put his head down and tried to run for it. Ran into a wall of Shenango defenders and didn't have any other place to go. Wilmington's going to have to punt the ball again. Smart Jessup back to punt. Smart Jessup is getting some nice punts off in the pregame drills, so we know he does have a really good punting foot, as we've seen before. Smart Jessup lets the punt go. End over end, it's going to take a big bounce for Wilmington.
Chris Johnson picks it up at the 15 to the 20. Rolls to the left side of the field. Now he gets a couple yards out of up to the 23, and a lot worse field position to start now for the Shenango Wildcats. They got the ball in excellent field position the last time on the 38. They had a big gainer in their first down from the scrimmage in the Wilmington territory, had another 3-4 yard gainer after that, and then the turnover, a fumble.
Well, I'll tell you what, on the last drive for the Shenango Wildcats, four plays for the drive, Alex Keddie touched the ball four times. So if I'm Wilmington defense, I am going to look out for number 47 from the Shenango Wildcats.
Full house backfield. DeCarbo will hand the ball this time to Jim Valenti, and it looks like Mr. Valenti is off to the races. 20, 15, 10, 5, touchdown, Shenango Wildcats.
Jim Valenti did not have anybody close to him. That's what happens when you bring all of your defenders in, as Wilmington did. Wilmington came with an all-out rush from their defensive backfield. Valenti with the ball found a small hole on the right-hand side, burst through that, and there was no one close to him. Valenti down the field so fast, by the time Wilmington reacted, the closest Wilmington player to Valenti was 25 yards. Valenti all on his own on a nice little jog into the end zone for Jim Valenti. 6 points for the Shenango Wildcats. They get on the board early. 2:32 to go in the first quarter.
Now the extra point attempt will be coming up here by Mike Walczak, as the Shenango Wildcats are up on top now, 6-0. Snap is down, the kick is up. No, the kick is not going to be any good. Blocked.
Kick was blocked at the line. Wilmington defense just put their hands up in the air and they knocked it down. And last Wilmington game we called, we saw how costly missed extra points were. So we'll have to see as this game progresses. But the main factor for the Shenango Wildcats, they do put 6 up on the board to Wilmington 0. Shenango leading the game, 2:32 to go in the first quarter.
And with 2:32 remaining and Shenango leading 6-0, we'll return in 30 seconds on the Tri-County stations. Being a
pet. This consumer message is a service of your credit union.
And we're back just in time for the kickoff. And it's going to roll past the Wilmington receiver. Now it's going to be picked up with the 6, eluding the defender down there, but then being stopped at the 8-yard line. And that's where the Wilmington Greyhounds will have to put the ball in play, trying to bring the ball back and having some trouble, Sean McConaughey.
Wilmington just running into all sorts of troubles earlier in this game. McConaughey, that's the second kick. Neither kick really has gotten off the ground that well, and they've been rolling and bouncing on the ground when they come to McConaughey, but both of them so far have seemed to get right past him. That time, by the time McConaughey picked up the ball, he was already down on the 5-yard line, got backed up about 15 yards, brought the ball back up to around the 8-yard line. Wilmington in really poor field position, not on the 8-yard line.
And trailing by 6 points. The handoff nearly broken there as they get out to the 14-yard line. Getting the call that time was Steve McConaughey, and he carried out to the 14. He was one tackle away from the 15.
Well, Sean McConaughey tried to make up for the loss, that the ball that just got away from him. McConaughey trying to do it all himself, and from the angle we are looking at, McConaughey looked like he was ready to break through before he just got tripped up. A Shenango player just tripped him up by the ankles and dropped him for picked up about 5 yards. Second down at 5, Wilmington.
A handoff to Smart Gesso. Smart Gesso tries the right side. Smart Gesso busts near first down territory on the 19-yard line. There's 1:26. The clock is running here in the first period.
We're going to have to look for Damon Hart to start throwing the ball. It seems like last year, Hart with a good season throwing the ball, a lot of good aerials.
First and 10 for the Greyhounds. That's a Smart now on the 19.
With Hart throwing the ball so well last year and then this year running into some problems early, Wilmington is pretty much stuck to the ground game. When they're on and they do well, when they struggle, then, you know, it's the ground game. If that's struggling, then Wilmington's really been in trouble. Right now they pick up the first down, and it is first and 10 for the Wilmington Greyhounds.
And the handoff gets going for a gain of a couple up to the 22. As coming out of the bottom of the pile is Sean McConaughey for a gain of 3. It'll be second down and 7.
Shenango's front line on their defense doing a good job tonight of containing the Wilmington Greyhounds. Something Wilmington was wanting to do with Shenango, Coach Zabetto said they need to contain those running backs for Shenango, but as we just saw, and in case you missed it, Jim Valenti for the Shenango Wildcats broke through for a 75-yard touchdown run. That's not your best containment when you can give up something like that.
Damon Hart will try to pass, but he's sworn by 3 Shenango defenders and dropped at the 15-yard line.
Something Wilmington's going to have to work on is that offensive line, because as we saw before, against the Leechburg team 2 weeks ago, as we keep alluding to that, when Wilmington played Leechburg, every time Damon Hart would go back to pass, it seemed like he didn't have any time to get himself set. And again, we've seen that tonight on 2 attempts that Damon Hart has tried to get. He's been swarmed both times.
That's the end of the first quarter. Shenango leads 6-0. We'll return to the field in 60 seconds. Your Tri-County stations.
Remember, please, only you can prevent forest fires. This message brought to you by the State Forest Service, this station, and the Advertising Council.
Welcome back to Wilmington Area High School. I'm Dave Barner along with Steve Shenemy tonight, reminding you, Westminster Titan football on the air tomorrow at the stations. 105 pregame, 130 kickoff from Findlay, Ohio. Right now, we're at Wilmington Area High School, ready to start the second period. Wilmington with the ball in their own 19, trailing Shenango 6-0. As we move the ball now from left to right with the reversal. And the pitch is going to be to Sean McConaughey, but there's a stoppage of play in the backfield by the officials.
They'll have to sort this out, and we'll have to see where we stand. McConaughey getting the ball quite a bit tonight, and Smart Gesso and McConaughey working the backfield. Kyle Freeman, only one carry, but it was a big one, a 15-yard pickup for the Wilmington Greyhounds, as we saw before. That's their biggest gainer of the night.
Illegal procedure will be the call against the Greyhounds. Third and 19 is the situation here. For the Greyhounds. Back on the 10. The pitch to McConaughey, he's clobbered at the 10. And a fourth down punt coming up for the Greyhounds.
Wilmington just not making it through on the conversions. Been the one first down they picked was Smart Gesso bowling through and picking up the first down by the nose of the football, and otherwise Wilmington coming up just short, and this time didn't really get close at all. They just couldn't get this drive going. They'll be punting the ball. Smart Gesso will be standing just inside his own end zone. Shenango's going to be getting the ball in excellent field position as they're waiting for the ball on the 40-yard line.
And back deep once again is their returner, Chris Johnson. He picks it up at the 45, cuts to the 40. That's Wilmington territory. Down to the 35-yard line. 3 flags on the field. We'll see what the penalty is.
Well, the flags are thrown to the backfield. Only one man went after the Shenango returner for Wilmington. And number 17 for Shenango Wildcats, Vincent Martwinski, was there pretty quickly. And I think we might have seen a clip on this play. We'll have to let them sort it out. But if things go as planned, Shenango will have the ball in excellent field position at the 35, but it looks like we'll just have to wait and see with the refs figure here.
Did not get the chance to see the symbol.
It is going to be a clip against the Shenango Wildcats, and they are going to mark the ball off from the spot of the foul. The flag was thrown all the way back at the 48-yard line, and when you mark 15 off from that, Chenango is going all the way back to their own 38-yard line. So what a huge loss that is, and of course, with the penalties the way they are now, marking it off from the spot of the foul, Chenango would have had the ball on the 35-yard line without the foul, and now they get marched all the way back to their own 38-yard line.
It will be first and 10, however, from the 38. The handoff, no gain. This time was Jim Valenti. He had the touchdown, but he stopped at the line of scrimmage.
Well, he ran into Tom Shimrock that time, and that's something that didn't happen when he broke it through for the touchdown. He was virtually untouched there, but this time Shimrock all over him. Picks up maybe half a yard on the play.
So it's going to be second down, a long nine for the Chenango Wildcats. The Wildcats lead 6-0 here at Wilmington, just starting the second period. 10:30 remains. Clock is running. William DeCarbo keeps the ball, rolls out, throws, incomplete. Had an intended receiver down there. He was open, but couldn't quite get it to Rob Creasy.
Well, Creasy was a big play man so far this year for the Wildcats. He has a couple touchdowns for himself. Good fake by William DeCarbo as he faked the inside handoff and caught the Wilmington defense a little bit, rolled out to his right and fired it to Creasy. And if Creasy would have held onto the ball, he would have been open for a pretty good size gain. He probably would have picked up about 15 yards on the play.
So now third down nine for the Wildcats, leading in the ball game 6-0 on their own 39-yard line. Double wing formation. Flanker out right, split end out left. The handoff. That was DeCarbo faking the handoff again, keeping the ball himself, running to the right side, getting a good gain of at least 8 in the play, down near the first down marker at the 48.
Again, it's going to be a close call, and the chain bend tonight on the sidelines are going to get their workout if the game keeps going like this. We'll have to see where they spot the ball, but we could be in for another measurement.
I think they're going to be spotting it a little bit short of the first down, about a yard short of the first down marker. It's going to be fourth down and less than a yard for the Wildcats on their own 47-yard line. And heading back to receive the punt is Margesso. Also back there, McConaughey. The punt will be put away at the 33-yard line of Chenango. Snap is good. The punt is away. McConaughey has to run after the ball. He falls with the ball. Still a loose ball. Goes back on it and falls on the ball at the 5-yard line as the punt was a good one. It was over McConaughey's head. He had to run back for the ball and decided to try to pick it up, but couldn't control the ball. Had to fall on the ball at the 5-yard line. It appears it might be out at the six-yard line for the Wilmington Greyhounds. Nonetheless, a bad situation.
McConaughey really having a tough night tonight on fielding the kicks. That time he looked as if he thought he was in position, and then all of a sudden took a few steps back, and the ball managed to get over his head. He was standing around the 25-yard line, but the ball kicked all the way back and tried to fall on it. The ball squirted loose again. Luckily for the Wilmington Greyhounds, McConaughey kept possession of the ball, but Wilmington backed all the way up to the 5-yard line.
Damon Hart gives the handoff, a gain up to the 8. And it was McConaughey with the carry, but a gain of only about 1.5 to 2 yards on the play, so it's going to be second down and a long 8.
Oh, McConaughey coming out of the ball game, and Kyle Freeman taking the play in for the Wilmington Greyhounds. Freeman with a big run earlier. We'll see if he gets the call again. Wilmington just about in the same territory as they were before on their last drive, so we'll see if Freeman gets the call this time to bring the ball through for the Wilmington Greyhounds.
Wing T for the Greyhounds. The wing back is in motion. The handoff to McConaughey. He gets Little up to the 10.
It is Freeman with a handoff, and Freeman picks up a couple yards, as you said. Brings it back up to around the 10-yard line. Wilmington's going to have to get the ball up to the 16-yard line to pick up the first down, so still looking at about 6.5 yards to go for the first down.
So a third down play. Unless Wilmington can convert this third down and 6 situation from their own 10-yard line, the Wildcats are going to be in excellent field position. So here comes the third down play. It's the wing T formation. The handoff on the draw, no first down. Heath Margesso got the call, but only could get to the 11. It's going to be fourth down for the Greyhounds.
Well, we're going to see this set up just exactly as we did before. Smarchesa was punting from his own end zone before, and with the ball on the 11-yard line, that's right about where he'll be this time, just about a step inside the end zone. Once again, back deep for Shenango will be Chris Johnson, number 20, 5'7", 130-pound sophomore. And as we saw before, Shenango would have been in excellent position, but there was a clip called, and that moved them back about 30 yards.
The punt is away. It's an excellent one by Heath Smargesso. Johnson finally picks it up at the 48, and he's crushed right there as he had to run back for the ball. Finally was able to retrieve it on a nice boot by Smargesso, and he didn't have much running room after that as he's hit hard at the Shenango Wildcat 47.5-yard line. But they'll be in excellent field position as we predicted.
Looks like Johnson might have been able to get around the end. Kyle Freeman grabbed a whole handful of jersey, spun it back around for Randy Young to just knock right back down on the ground. So Shenango a little bit deeper than where we thought they would be, with Wilmington punting from their end zone. Shenango with the ball on about the 48-yard line.
The handoff for a big gainer down to the 40-yard line, carrying the ball that time for the Shenango Wildcats was Ron Iwaneko. And that's going to be a first down for the Wildcats down to the 39-yard line.
Well, they were talking before the game about how tough the Shenango running game is. With we saw earlier Alex Keddie, the entire first possession was his as he moved the ball down the field. Shenango's second possession, we saw Jim Valenti with a 75-yard touchdown. And now it seems to be Ron Iwaneko's turn as he picked up about 10 on that play.
It's the wing tee. And a handoff that time was to Keddie. And Keddie gets down to the 35-yard line. So it's going to be second and 5 for the Shenango Wildcats. It's a 5-yard gain.
McKinney's the biggest one of the running backs for the Shenango Wildcats, coming in at 6'1", 175 pounds. Iwaneko only 155 pounds, and also Valenti weighs only 150, 6'1", wiry but quick, as we saw in his touchdown, 75 yards.
DeCarbo pitches the ball out in the option. He gotta get it out to Valenti, but Valenti is gonna be strung out and is gonna be stopped at the line of scrimmage.
Well, that's frustrating for Tom Shimrock of the Wilmington Greyhounds because he thought that he had DeCarbo racked up for a sack in the backfield. But before DeCarbo went down or was ruled in possession, he flipped the ball out to Valenti, and Valenti picks up a few yards for the Shenango Wildcats.
Got more than I thought, Steve, down near the first down marker at about the 30-yard line. It's going to be third down and 1 in Wilmington Greyhound territory. Shenango leads 6-0. The handoff for the first down, and there's another touchdown possibility. That's going to be another Shenango touchdown. Alex Kenny got the ball and then did some great cutting. Looked like he'd be stopped near the line of scrimmage. It eluded a couple tacklers on the way to the end zone, so it's going to be a great run by Alex Kenny.
That certainly is. I think Smargesso thought he had him, and then Kenny with a big move on Smargesso to leave him in his tracks, and also John Tellis. Put a freeze on John Tellis, and a big move to the right, and Keddie just burst through the end zone for a big touchdown for Shenango. 12-0 right now. Touchdown comes with 5 minutes and 2 seconds to go in the first half of this game. Shenango's going to see if they can get this extra point off the ground.
They're going to go for a two-point conversion to try to make up for their missed one the last time. And there is a two-point conversion. The handoff was given out to Iwaneko, and he gets the 2 points, so it's 14-0.
That's the second time in this drive that we've seen the pitch from quarterback William DeCarbo. Again, DeCarbo looked like he was in trouble, and then with the pitch out to Ron Iwaneko, planned pitch that play. Wilmington defense a bit frustrated on the sidelines as they thought they had Shenango wrapped up on that drive, and then the big play hurt him once again. So two Shenango touchdowns on two big runs, 75 yards on the first one, and then we saw about 30 yards on this one. So once again, the big play is hurting the Wilmington Greyhounds.
We'll be back for the kickoff with the Greyhounds trailing 14-0 in 30 seconds.
Grant a refund or exchange an unhealthy animal. But keep the bill of sale that proves you purchased the animal and did not just adopt it.
This consumer message is a service of your credit union.
Back to action. We just missed the kickoff. McConaughey got the return as we were gone and got a good run back that time up to the 43-yard line of the Wilmington Greyhounds.
Well, McConaughey with a good job of, you could tell all he wanted to do that time was field the ball cleanly, as he'd been having trouble before. Fielded the ball excellent, and a really good run back. Just kept everything going, pushing people out of his way. Brought the ball all the way back up to the 43-yard line, Wilmington's best starting field position of the night.
Damon Hart has been the quarterback all night. And the handoff is Malone back in the backfield. That time it is McConaughey. And they're going to get up to the 45-yard line for a gain of three. It's going to be second down and seven.
Wilmington yet to complete a pass tonight. Damon Hart only with two attempts, and both times under heavy pressure, one time sacked and the other time run out of bounds, stopped for a gain of about maybe 3 yards on the play.
It's the I formation. The wing backs off on the left side of the lineup, split end out here to the right and the near side. The fake handoff, now the pitch to Smargesso. He stopped in the backfield for a loss. Back at the original line of scrimmage, it's going to be third and 10 coming up.
Well, that's what Damon Hart was working on with the offense before the game tonight, is working on those handoffs. Excellent fake on the inside handoff. And then Hart spinning out to his left side with the pitch to Smargesso. Everything went exactly as they wanted. Unfortunately for the Wilmington Greyhounds, the Shenango defense read it perfectly. And as soon as Smargesso was flipped the ball, he was knocked down. It's going to be a loss of three on a play, and the ball's going to be marked down to the original line of scrimmage, third down and 10.
Third down play coming up here for the Greyhounds. They trail in the ball game 14-0 with 3:21 remaining in the first half. Damon Hart will pass, rolling to his right, fires, complete at the beyond the first down marker. It was complete down there to Jens Jorgensen, and it looks like it's past the first down marker. It'll be first and 10 for the Greyhounds of Shenango territory on the Shenango 46-yard line.
Well, Hart once again under heavy pressure. That time it came from Chris Johnson, and Hart quick enough to get out of the way. Johnson coming full speed down around Hart's back, and Hart spinning off to his right side and on the run when he threw the ball. Excellent play from Damon Hart to Jens Jorgensen. Wilmington picks up the first down on the 46-yard line.
The handoff to Smargesso. Smargesso cuts for 4 yards down to the 41-yard line. It'll be second and six.
That time Smargesso just trying to bulldoze his way through, put the head down and tried to carry as many people as he could. He broke through for a pickup of about 5 yards. It'll be second down and five. The ball on the 41-yard line for Wilmington. 2 minutes and 35 seconds to go in a half to get something going.
Wilmington trailing 14-0. On a couple big running plays from the Wildcats. The handoff to Smargesso. Smargesso has the first down. Smargesso down to the 26-yard line. First and 10, Greyhounds.
Smargesso almost broke that through for 6 points for the Wilmington Greyhounds. Ron Iwaneko there just to trip him up. He was the only man Smargesso had to go around. That time Smargesso running just about the same play he did last time, going through the left side of the line. That time Smargesso made his way through, had open field in front of him, and then as we said, Ron Iwaneko the only man to beat, and Iwaneko grabbed him by the ankles. But still a big game for the Wilmington Greyhounds as the ball is now down on the 28-yard line. First down and 10, 152 and running for the Wilmington Greyhounds in the first half.
And now the Greyhounds have to go against the clock. Deepest penetration for them in the ballgame so far. And a handoff for a couple yards down to the 23-yard line. This time the handoff went to number 20 in the ballgame.
I believe it was number 40, Chad Morris, with a handoff that time for the Wilmington Greyhounds. Morris is senior.
So it's going to be second down and six from the Shenango Wildcat 23. Trailing 14-0. Clock down to 1:17 and a half. High formation. Damon Hart gives it to Smargesso. No, he doesn't. Instead, he gives it over to the other side and getting a good run into play, Sean McConaughey, but he's going to be short of the first down. He's down across the 20 to the 19, 18-yard line.
I'll tell you what, if he would have given that to Smargesso, it would have been 6 points because Smargesso broke through with nobody around him. Smargesso looks to have called timeout for the Wilmington Greyhounds, waiting on a ruling.
It's going to be a third down and one, it appears, from our vantage point. The ball down at around the 18-yard line of Shenango. And now there is timeout in the field with the Greyhounds trailing 14-0. We'll return in 30 seconds on your Tri-County stations.
Credit Union.
1:02 remains in the first half. The Greyhounds threatening. On the Shenango 18-yard line, third down and one. The Greyhounds trailing 14-0 to the Wildcats. They would certainly like to punch it in here at halftime and get some morale uplift, even though they still go in trailing. Damon Hart will give the ball off to number 44, Sean McConaughey, who has the first down, down around the 13-yard line.
McConaughey's seeing a lot of action tonight in the game, and he's taking advantage of it, making the most of his opportunities tonight. The Wilmington ground game on this drive has really been picking up. That's what Wilmington's going to have to do if they're going to win this game, is thread through the Shenango defense, which, as we said, has been iffy throughout the last couple weeks.
Clock running, 45 seconds in the first half. The time against the Greyhounds. Damon Hart will look to pass. Looks to the end zone. Cannot have his receiver. He had the ball there, but the receiver couldn't handle it. Jens Jorgensen, as he was hit hard as the ball was delivered.
Well, Hart did an excellent job of staying in the pocket that time. Had Shenango defensemen all around him, clawing at him, trying to get to him. And Hart stood tall in the pocket, and he fired a strike to Jens Jorgensen. But Jorgensen couldn't hold on to it. The ball went right through his hands. That would have been 6 points in the back of the end zone. For one, Wilmington now second down and 10, 38 seconds to work with. The ball still on the 12-yard line.
All right, now the incomplete pass will stop the clock at 38 seconds. Second and 10 from the 13 to the Wildcats. Damon Hart will be back to pass. He's under pressure. He's sacked. A big loss on the play. Back to the 27-yard line as the Wilmington coaching staff in the next press box over here, Steve. We're not happy with that. You can hear the clipboards being thrown and the feet being stomped.
We could feel that one.
That is going to be a big loss, and that's going to put the Greyhounds out of even their field goal kicker, Adam Clapper's possibility. He can kick 30-yard field goals, but this one is now back at the 27-yard line, third down, and a long 22 yards to go with the clock now stopped at 30 seconds.
Well, so far in this ball game, Shenango's big play man has been Jim Valenti, and it was Valenti with a big touchdown run earlier, and Valenti stopping temporarily stopping the Wilmington drive this time. Damon Hart didn't have anywhere to go. By the time he looked up, Valenti was in there so quick coming from his defensive halfback position. Damon Hart didn't have anywhere to go, and Valenti with a big sack, and the Wilmington ball now all the way back, as you said, on the 32-yard line. So a huge loss for the Wilmington Greyhounds with only 30 seconds to work with in this half.
Well, play will be in. The Greyhounds have called a timeout. Third down at 22 from the Greyhound, 27. What a turnaround.
Certainly, and Adam Clapper loosening up on the sidelines just in case Wilmington does get close enough for Clapper to get a shot at the field goal.
Damon Hart back to pass. Looks over the hands of Jens Jorgensen, nearly intercepted by William DeCarbo. And so now the fourth down play is coming up. With 25 seconds remaining in the ball game, there's little doubt that the Greyhounds will be trying for it here. Well, not in the ball game, the half. Our apologies.
With 25 yards to go for the first down and the ball on the 32-yard line, you can look for Wilmington to go deep. Surprisingly, on the last play, Hart tried to get the quick pass off and only took about a one-step drop. With the Shenango defense swarming as it is, that's a little dangerous, but Hart didn't get hit that time, but then the pass went incomplete to Jorgensen anyway, so we'll have to look for the big gainer this time.
There we go. Last shot for the Greyhounds in this half. 25 seconds remain. The Greyhounds trail 14-0. Hart is back to pass, straight back. He looks to the end zone. Incomplete. Had it in the corner of the end zone, but Heath-Smart Jesso could not get there. The ball was in the deep corner of the right side of the end zone, over the defenders, but a little bit beyond Heath-Smart Jesso's reach.
Well, it would have taken a great catch by Smart Jesso to keep that ball in bounds, because as the ball landed, the chalk was flying on the sidelines, and Smart Jesso really would have had to do a little toe-stepping on the sidelines to keep that ball in bounds. Would he have been able to come up with it? The ball thrown just a few yards over Heath-Smart Jesso's head. Wilmington defense will have to come back in and with 18 seconds to go, contain this Shenango offense from coming up with a big play once again. 14-0 is the score. 18 seconds to go in the first half. Shenango's ball on the 25-yard line.
And a whistle.
Shenango just downing the ball. Quarterback William DeCarbo taking the snap and just putting the knee down.
The clock will run out here now. They do not have to run another play. 3-2-1. That's the end of the first half as the Shenango Wildcats lead at the end of the first half. 14-0 over the Greyhounds here at Wilmington Area High School. We'll return to the field in 60 seconds on your Tri-County stations.
Trojo's Restaurant. Now, Newcastle has the second highest number of escapes among the state's three youth development centers.
Down in their own end, but Shenango has come fighting back every time. Two big touchdowns, and Jim Valenti was probably the biggest play of the night, stopping Wilmington and sacking quarterback Damon Hart and dropping Hart for a 15-yard loss as we get set for action in the second half.
And we're underway. And the kickoff being picked up at the 25 to the 30 to the 33-yard line. Returning the kickoff for the Shenango Wildcats, Chris Johnson. And we're underway with football in the second half, a bit delayed. 14-0 is the lead. The ball will be down at the 34-yard line of Shenango Wildcats. They'll hold the ball to put it in play. I'm Dave Varner along with Steve Shenavy. Welcome along to our Tri-County broadcast. Triple stations tonight. WBZY, the flagship station. WWNW, New Wilmington following along. And Cable 9 and Channel 18 Adelphia on tape delay tonight. And the handoff is for a gain of about 3 or 4 on the play. Up to the 39-yard line.
Once again, it's going to be up to the Wilmington front line to try and contain the Shenango running game. If Shenango is going to run anything, if the first half was any indication on how Shenango is going to run the second half, then that's exactly it. They're going to run the second half, and they're not going to air the ball out very much. We saw them throw a few times early in the game, and then once the running game started working, they stuck with it.
The wing T formation, the split end out to the near side, the left side of the Shenango line. And the handoff is for a big gainer and a first down. Carrying that time for the Shenango Wildcats.
It's Alex Kenny with the carry for the Wildcats. Once again, Kenny with a big touchdown in the first half. And that's good enough for a first down as they move the chains. First down to 10 for the Shenango Wildcats. And they're going to mark the ball on the 48-yard line.
They're still in the Shenango end of the field, but moving the ball well on their first offensive series. Again, the wing T, the wing out in the left, split end out in the left. T formation. DeCarbo does the pitch. And going down the left side and getting good gain on the play down into Wilmington territory, carrying the ball that time, Ron Iwaneko. And he is down inside the Wilmington Greyhound 45 to the 42-yard line, of flag on a play.
Well, that's the third time that Shenango has used the pitch tonight, and all three times it's worked very well. Kyle Freeman on the stop for the Wilmington Greyhounds.
So that big gain is going to be brought back, Steve, a clipping call against the Shenango Wildcats. So they'll be moving back into their own territory.
Well, that's going to be a big play on the penalty there, and it's going to move Shenango back. As we said, with the clipping, it'll move him back another 15 yards. We'll have to see where the ball ends up being spotted as they mark it off. Going to mark it back from the spot of the foul. The foul was committed about the Wilmington 46, so the ball is going to go back. And they're going to mark it back to the Shenango 38-yard line.
And now that's where the ball will be put in play. First down and 20. For the Shenango Wildcats, the Wildcats lead here at Wilmington 14-0. We're just starting the second half. 10-18 remains third period. Wing T formation right this time. DeCarbo will pass. He looks long. It is in and out of the hands of the intended receiver down there to Rob Creasy, as he was standing down at the Wilmington 40-yard line.
Creasy's our big receiver, and that time running neck and neck with Heath Smart Gesso, and it looked like a little bit of bumping going on back and forth there. And by the time the ball was thrown, both Smart Gesso and Creasy went out for the ball. Neither of them came down with it. Creasy with the best shot to get it, but he couldn't hold on to it either, so it goes as an incomplete pass.
And so now a second down to 20 coming up from the Shenango Wildcat 38-yard line. They'll have to move into Wilmington territory on the 42 for the first down. They come out with a wing T formation right, split end out to the right side as well. And the handoff this time is for a good gain. Here comes the first down. Iwaneko has good running room. Down into Wilmington, the highest territory at the 40-yard line. First and 10 for the Shenango Wildcats.
Good running again for Shenango, as we've seen. Iwaneko that time, never say die, as he looked like he was going to get dragged down. Kept the legs going, made a quick spin, and broke through for another 10 yards. Kyle Freeman once again on the stop for Wilmington. So far in the second half, it's been Freeman on Iwaneko.
First and 10, Shenango in Greyhound territory on the 41-yard line. They've been moving the ball well on the ground tonight. Wing T right, split end right. Quarterback to Carbo. The handoff for no gain this time. As getting the handoff from Bill DeCarbo that time was Alex Kenny. We'll give him a yard in the play. It'll be second down and 9. A ball just inside the Wilmington 40-yard line for a gain of 1.
They're going to give him a gain of just about 1.5 is where they're going to spot it. It'll give him second down and 8 for the Shenango Wildcats. And so far, as we thought in the second half, Shenango has been run the ball some more.
Full house backfield this time. And the handoff this time is for a couple-yard gain to Jim Valenti. He's going to get down to the 37-yard line, so it's going to be a third down and 5 coming up for the Shenango Wildcats in Wilmington territory on the 37.
You know, Dave, you talk about the toughness of these two teams, and to figure out where it comes from, you don't have to look any further than the sidelines. As we're up here seeing our breasts and shivering a bit, and you look down, and both Wilmington coach John Sabeto and Shenango coach Frank Bongiovingo in their short-sleeved shirts on the sideline enjoying the action.
DeCarbo will go in the option. He will finally pitch it out, and they'll be short of the first down. DeCarbo held the ball to the very last minute and then pitched, and Jim Valenti was able to get a couple yards on the play, but it's going to be a fourth down and 2 coming up for the Shenango Wildcats on the Wilmington 33.
Well, it doesn't look like that was a planned pitch because DeCarbo held onto the ball for so long, and by the time that he did finally pitch the ball to Valenti, didn't really have a chance to go anywhere with it.
Here come the Wildcats, fourth down. The Greyhounds would like to hold them here, trailing 14-0. A first down for the Wildcats, but keep the drive moving towards the goal. The handoff is going to be mighty close. I think the Greyhounds have stopped them. It appears from here that the Greyhounds have stopped the first down attempts. And they do. They're going to give the ball to the Greyhounds, first and 10.
Wilmington with just a swarm of defenders on Shenango, led by Sean McConaughey and also Clayton Pratt in on the stop, as well as about 3 or 4 other Wilmington defenders. They stop Shenango short when they just their first down or fourth down attempt. Wilmington takes over the ball, and they're going to be on their own 33-yard line to start this drive.
And that's going to be a big uplift for the Wilmington Greyhounds as they're able to stop Shenango on a fourth down and 2. Fourth down to 1.5, really.
Exactly, and still a lot of time left in the ballgame, 7:23 and counting in the third quarter. If Wilmington can get something going here, then they'll be in good shape.
And the handoff this time is going to be going ahead to Kyle Freeman. And Kyle Freeman is going to get a hold ahead to the 37-yard line. It's going to be second down and 6 coming up.
Freeman only picking up a few yards in the play, giving 4 yards on the pickup. Freeman not running the ball as much tonight. We've seen McConaughey run the ball quite a bit in the first half. As a matter of fact, I believe he was the leading ball carrier for the Wilmington Greyhounds in the first half.
Greyhounds will come out with the wing T formation. Wing out on the right side. That wing back is in motion. The wing back will get the call. The wing back gets no gain in the play, getting the call that time for the Wilmington Greyhounds.
Joe Kohler with the carrying the ball for the Wilmington Greyhounds for no gain. Kohler only a sophomore for the Wilmington Greyhounds.
So now a third down play coming up for the Greyhounds. Heading off Kyle Freeman. Back in McConaughey. Big third down play for the Greyhounds. They had a big one on defense a couple downs ago. Now they need one on offense to keep the action going, trailing in the ball game 14-0 to the Wildcats. We'll have a couple of Wildcats Saturday evening games on WBZY. There's not going to be a first down. It's going to be a loss in the backfield. Wilmington will be punting.
Wilmington has to have the confidence to be able to throw the ball. I think that's what they might be lacking right now. As we said before, when Damon Hart is on, then he is virtually an unstoppable quarterback, but he's run into a few problems this year, and now when Wilmington needs the big play, they don't even seem to be calling on him as much as they would have maybe earlier in the season or last year. That time with a third down and 9, a must situation, Wilmington tries for the trap and got trapped themselves as they end up with a 1-yard loss.
Heath Margesa will punt to DeCarbo. DeCarbo will pick up the ball on the 36. He'll go ahead to the 40, to the 41. Boy, he felt it there. It's a 42 as he got stopped with a crunch. William DeCarbo brings the ball back to the 42-yard line. It'll be 43-yard line as they spot the ball. Still in the Chenango end of the field. Chenango leads 14-0.
What a great job by DeCarbo, though, to elude the first man downfield for Wilmington. The ball rolled almost to a dead stop. DeCarbo just kind of looking at it like he's going to down it. All of a sudden, picked up the ball, skirted out of the way of a few Wilmington players, and it ended up picking up about 6 yards on the return. However, that's not exactly what you want to see when your quarterback's returning your punts for you. You don't want to see him running full steam into a host of Wilmington players.
Rob Creasy splits out to the left side. And the handoff is for a big gainer. Carrying the ball that time on the play was Ron Iwaneko. And down to the Wilmington Greyhound 40-yard line, first and 10 for the Chenango Wildcats as they move well on the ground. A well-coached team, as always, with Frank Bonzovingo, very highly experienced coach. The Chenango Wildcats will always be respectable.
Iwaneko with the second man through the hole that time with the big gainer. And something Chenango's been doing tonight, their best running attacks have been right through the line. What they're doing is just running them right off the center, off on the right side. And that's when they're picking them. They're not running them big around the end, making the big gains, usually right up through the middle.
Iwaneko will get the call again. He gets down to the 39-yard line. He's going to get a gain of only one that time. It's going to be second down and 9 coming up for the Wildcats.
That time Iwaneko tried to come around the left end, and Terry Young right there to put the hit on him. Young came flying over the top to stop Iwaneko, a pickup of only about a yard. Second down and 9. Scores 14-0. Chenango Wildcats leading the Wilmington Greyhounds. 3 minutes and 57 seconds and counting in the third quarter.
14-0, a 2-touchdown, 2-extra-point lead for Chenango. The pitch this time is going to go to Jim Valenti. Jim will get ahead down to the Wilmington Greyhound 34-yard line, and it's going to be a 3rd and 4 coming up for Chenango. Make it a long 4, closer to 5.
Well, Chenango is looking for better luck than they had last time when they were in a 3rd down situation. You could look, as we look on the field for the Chenango Wildcats, they're going to have their big running backs in. Alex Keddy is in the game, and you can look for him.
DeCarbo will roll right. He's being chased. He now throws, has the first down completion down at the 22-yard line, completing the ball down there to Alex Keddy. And it's going to be 1st and 10 for the Wildcats.
That time, Chenango quarterback William DeCarbo fakes the handoffs through the hole, ran for himself, and looked like he was going to get run out of bounds. Saw Keddy just in time coming across the field his own way, dumped it off to Kelly or to Keddy. Keddy in good position to pick up the first down and a few more to go with it. The ball's going to be on the 24-yard line. 1st and 10, Chenango Wildcats.
Wing T left, split ends out to the left side. Ball in the right hash mark for the Chenango Wildcats. 1st and 10 for the Wilmington 19. The handoff to Alex Keddy. He gets ahead for a couple yards, down to the 22-yard line. 2nd and 8 coming up.
Once again, the Chenango running game has been running through this Wilmington defense. Wilmington defense going to have to toughen up inside. Chenango, as we said before, running right through the middle of the line. That's something that Wilmington's going to have to do, is key right on the center of that line. They're containing them to the outside. The linebackers for Wilmington doing a good job, but those down linemen are going to have to work on keeping the holes from forming to the inside that Chenango is taking advantage of.
Ball on the 21-yard line. The handoff this time is going to get ahead down to the 14-yard line, or the flag on the play.
Iwaneko, Iwaneko with the carry once again, and the flag was thrown just as Iwaneko was stopped on the 10-yard line.
It's going to be a holding call against Chenango, so that's going to put a bit of damper on a good run by Iwaneko.
Now, Chenango would have been in excellent position if the run would have stood on the 10-yard line with a 1st and goal. Still waiting for a decision from the field, but we did have a call of offensive holding against the Chenango Wildcats as they pick up the flag, and they're going to march the ball back now.
And so now it's going to be a repeat of 2nd down with a long way back at the 29-yard line instead of down on the 10.
Going to be second down and 16 for Shenango. As we said, the ball on the 29-yard line.
Full house backfield. Three across the back behind DeCarbo. DeCarbo fakes the handoff. He will throw. He has the receiver. No! In and out of the hands of the intended receiver down there. He was wide open, but the ball falls incomplete. Down around the 10-yard line.
That's the tight end, Chris Riley. And Riley was just in perfect position to make that catch. Perfectly thrown ball, hit him right in the numbers on the run. And Riley just juggled the ball two or three times and looked like he was just in position to pull it in. And the ball bounced off of his pads and just kicked away from him. He couldn't pull it in. That would have been 6 points for Shenango. And that's upsetting when something like that happens, especially now that it's third down at 15.
That was open field to the end zone. In motion, Iwaneko. DeCarbo will roll again the pass. He's going to be sacked to the loose ball. Wilmington Greyhounds on top of it. Was he down before the recovery? We'll
see. I think they might say that his knee was down. The referee is standing on the spot where the quarterback was down, and I believe that's what he is going to rule.
Lee Brumball was on top of the ball for the Greyhounds, but the fumble was created by the ground. So the Shenango Wildcats will now be facing a fourth down. They appear to be electing to punt and pin Wilmington deep, even though the ball is located in the Wilmington 34-yard line.
Oh, we'll have to see how good of an angle the Shenango punter could put on the ball, because the ball is spotted on the 39-yard line. The punter standing on about the 45.
That's Valenti. And it's going to go out of bounds. Did it go out of bounds in the end zone? See where they're going to mark the ball. The official standing at the 9-yard line. Now it looks like it's going to have gone into the end zone. It was headed for the out of bounds. No, it's on the 9-yard line.
What happened is the ball was kicked so far out of bounds, the ball actually touched the ground, what would have been deep in the end zone. But since it was kicked out at such an angle, they're going to mark it where the ball went out of bounds, which appears to be right around the 9-yard line. So Wilmington deep in their own, backed up against the goal line here. First and 10, trying to get something started. Just over a minute left in the third quarter. Wilmington on the 9-yard line.
Damon Hart will hand off for no gain. And so second and 10 coming up. Wilmington trails 14-0. Wilmington pinned back deep on their 9-yard line.
Sophomore Joe Kohler bringing the play in for the Wilmington Greyhounds. And with Kohler coming into the game, it's going to be Chad Morris stepping out for the play for Wilmington. A little exchange of running backs. Wilmington again with the ball still on the 9-yard line. Second down and 10. Gonna have to get out of this hole that they've kind of fallen into.
Wing T formation. The wing is in motion. The handoff that time was going to go to McConaughey. McConaughey is going to get maybe a yard on the play. And so third down and long coming up. Well, they will give him a yard. Third down and 9.
Wilmington not bursting through the holes the way that they wanted to. Again, we've seen their running game stalled by a tough defense. Shenango defense really playing tough tonight and stopping that Wilmington game.
And now the quarter has run out. That's the end of the third quarter. The score at the end of the third quarter, Shenango leads 14-0. We'll return in 60 seconds on your Tri-County stations. Back at Wilmington High School, I'm Dave Barnard along with Steve Shenemy with Tri-County Football and WBZY. And Steve, that big defensive play at the end of the first half is looming big right now. No scoring in the third period.
So far, that's definitely the play of the ball game. Absolutely no scoring in the third period, and no one really even close to scoring. Most of the actions we saw was in midfield. Currently, Wilmington in a little bit of trouble themselves. They're faced with a third down and 9, and they have the ball only on the 10-yard line.
A big third down play coming up for the Greyhounds right now, Steve, offensively. Starting the fourth period, Damon Hart steps back to pass. Damon cannot get the ball away. There's a loose ball down there. And and I think it's going to be retained by Wilmington, but they will have to punt the ball away as Damon only stepped back about two steps, and he did not have a chance to get the ball even into the air.
That's what we were saying before, and even before Hart got sacked on the play at the end of the second quarter, he did the same thing, Hart with only about a one-step drop, and that time didn't have a chance. What Hart did that time, he looked Jens Jorgensen all the way from the line of scrimmage until he ended up getting sacked. And Jorgensen covered so well, Hart didn't have anywhere else to go. With only the two-step drop, he had people on top of him. He didn't have anywhere to go, and it was a sack for Shenango.
Svargesso from the end zone. Ball nearly blocked. It's being picked up by DeCarver on the fly. Down to the 25, to the 20. Good cut by DeCarver to the 15, the 10, the 5. Nice run by William DeCarbo and a return.
What a great run by DeCarbo. Short punt, and DeCarbo fielded the ball on the 30, but looked like he'd get stopped right at the 25. Made a quick move to get through the inside and then just started weaving between Wilmington defenders. Burst through a hole and finally tripped himself up as he stretched out and ended up on the 5-yard line, but it looked like he tripped himself up. His chance of going in for the touchdown.
Unbelievable run. Some great cutting. And excellent balancing act, because he looked like he was going to stumble and fall, but kept on his feet. Now Shenango is threatening, leading 14-0. The ball in the 5 of Wilmington here in the fourth quarter. The handoff to Alex Keddy will get down to the 2. It's going to be second and goal from there.
And this is where Wilmington's in trouble, because Shenango has those big backs that they've been using. On the 2-yard line, second down and 1, they're going to put it on the 1-yard line. So second and goal from just about 2 feet away from the end zone. And with Shenango's running backs, you could look out. Could be some fireworks pretty soon for Shenango.
With the running ability of their quarterback, that's an offensive threat as well. Now's the wing T formation left. The handoff, Alex Keddy just runs into the end zone untouched. And it's going to be another Shenango score.
Keddy virtually untouched on that one, right off the left guard. Not a Wilmington player touched him. One person down, and Keddy just jumped right over him and waltzed into the end zone for an easy touchdown for Shenango. Only a 1-yard run, but it counts for 6 points. 20-0, 10-11 to go in the ball game. Shenango going to go for the extra point this time as Shenango's kicker,
Walzak, it appears. Snap is down, the kick is up, and this one's good, and Shenango leads 21-0 with 10-11 remaining in the fourth period. We'll return in 30 seconds on your Tri-County stations. We're back at Wilmington High School, where the home crowd is quiet right now. 21-0, the Shenango lead, the first scoring in the second half. And it's really set up by great defense, first by Shenango, forcing Smargesso to punt out of his own end zone, and then a great run back by William DeCarbo down to the 5-yard line, a 25-yard return, and two plays later into the end zone. This one's being picked up by McConaughey. He cuts to the 30, a 35-40 down to the end zone, down to the sideline, rather, down to the 43-yard line before he's knocked out of bounds, and a nice run back.
It certainly was a nice run back for the Wilmington Greyhounds, and the thing is, if he wouldn't have stepped out of bounds, he had open field in front of him. Just tried to get around the end of the one blocker, or the one defender he had to beat. Almost got around him, but stepped out of bounds in the process, so they're going to spot the ball on the 43-yard line. Still good field position for the Wilmington Greyhounds.
And now the Greyhounds, with their backs to the wall, trailing by 3 touchdowns, need offense right now to get back into the ballgame. On to 43, the Shenango Wildcats have been impressive on defense tonight, as well as grinding the ball out in the ground. Damon Hart will pass again. He throws, interception, and the Shenango Wildcats have intercepted Alex Keddy with the interception down to the 33-yard line of the Greyhounds.
Well, Hart once again only took that one-step drop, and that's been nothing but trouble for Damon Hart tonight in the ballgame. Threw that ball, perfect strike right to Alex Keddy. It's just a shame for Wilmington that Alex Keddy plays for Shenango, because perfect pass to Keddy, and Keddy with the return had a lot of open ground in front of him before Smargesso came up from behind and dragged him down to the ground. But now Shenango again going to be starting their drive from the 32-yard line of Wilmington, so they're in good shape.
The clock is down to 9:37. Wing T left, split end out to the left.
The handoff is to Iwaneko. He will not get anything. He'll be stopped short of the line of scrimmage at the 33-yard line.
.914 and counting to go in this ball game as Chenango 21-0. They're leading and they're threatening once again. That's going to be a loss of, they might give them a little bit of gain on the play. It's still going to go down to second down and 10. It's a matter of inches.
Second down and 10 for Chenango and Wilmington territory leading 21-0. After a couple of fakes, the handoff is to Jim Valenti this time, and he doesn't get much. It's going to be a third down and 10 coming up, but there's three flags down here on the play as the whistle was blown.
That's going to be a questionable call. What they're going to do is they're going to call number 84, Clayton Pratt, for the late hit. And Pratt did have a late hit because the Chenango runner was down on the ground when Pratt hit him, but again, what it is it's just your basic bump, and just the fact that it came after the first whistle had blown is going to count for the late hit, but really that's something Wilmington didn't need to do, and that wasn't necessary. The runner was already down, but then again, from Wilmington's point, it wasn't much of a hit either to call a penalty on.
Well, it means 15 yards from the end of the run, though, and that means it's going to be down on the 16-yard line, so it's going to be a costly hit because they were holding Chenango. It would have been a third down with little gain again. Now the handoff this time is for, again, little gain, only about a half-yard gain. This time the handoff is to Valenti. Wilmington defense is holding tough on the running game right now, but the penalty really cost them.
That's what it is, and we saw one other penalty before that really hurt too. So when they're, you know, the Wilmington defense is keeping Chenango to these short gains. That time we saw Kyle Freeman going down low and putting the stop on Valenti, and as we said before, how many times we have to say it, the big play is killing the Wilmington Greyhounds tonight and really helping out to Chenango Wildcats. Ball's on the 15-yard line.
Second down and 10, Alex Kenny with the call. Alex Kenny cuts down to the 3-yard line. It's going to be a first and goal for the Chenango Wildcats from the 3.
Kenny just plays like a really big back, and he's really having a good night tonight. That time Kenny straight up through the middle, got to about the 5-yard line. Looked like if he would have kept going straight, he might have been able to power his way into the end zone. Thought he saw an opening on the right side, tried to make the cut, got held up, but still the ball's down to the 3-yard line. 7:45 and counting. Wilmington defense really going to have to play tough now to stop this, because if this ball goes in the end zone, this game's over.
We'll have a couple Chenango Wildcats Saturday evening games on WBZY. Of course, we'll see Chenango and Laurel. Now Chenango is going to call timeout. Timeout Chenango, 7:27 remaining in the ball game. They lead 21-0, trying to ice the game now. We'll return to the field in 60 seconds near Tri-County stations.
Publishing House and this station remind you to read for your life.
Right hash mark. First and goal for the Wildcats. Already leading 21-0. 7:27 remaining in the ball game. The handoff is going to be for no gain on that play. Wilmington hangs tough. It was given to Ron Iwaneko, but he doesn't get anything, so it's second and goal from the 3.
Again, that Wilmington defense, they're really fooling us tonight. There's no other way to put it. They seem to play tough for two plays, and then the third play they get burnt. So it's really hard to tell. That time, no gain once again, and they held Iwaneko that time, and good play for the Wilmington defense. Second down and goal, ball still on the 3-yard line for Chenango.
Alex Kenny and Iwaneko in the background. The pitch to Iwaneko. He's in the end zone. Touchdown. And the Chenango Wildcats are up by a score of 27-0. And there's an injury down there. Is that Iwaneko down? In the end zone.
Iwaneko kind of went in the end zone a little awkwardly. Tried to dive it in and got cut underneath a little bit. Had his legs cut out from under him as he went in the end zone. And Chenango trainers out on the field tending to him.
With the injury timeout in the field, let's take our own 30-second timeout. We'll return to 30 seconds on your Tri-County stations. A very big lead right now for the Chenango Wildcats, 27-0. And Wilmington's not going to be facing any easy opponent next week either in Monaca. 6 minutes and 51 seconds remains. He will be able to walk off, though. That's a good sign.
Little ginger on the
on the left leg there, but now Iwaneko is running it off, and he looks like he'll be okay, just on the ground for a few minutes, and now he's jogging off to the sidelines.
And now Shenango will try for the 28-point lead. They've held Wilmington scoreless, 27-0. The extra point attempt coming up by Mike Walczak. Here is the snap. The snap is down. The kick is up. And the kick is no good. So it's a 27-0 lead. We'll return to the field in 30 seconds with Shenango leading on your Tri-County stations. Back at Wilmington Area High School, Wilmington set to receive the kickoff. Wilmington not having to do that except to start the second half as they have been held scoreless. Here is the kick. Picked up on the fly by McConaughey. He cuts to the right side of the field to the 30, and that's all he's going to get out of it. Receiving the ball on the left side, cutting across the right side of the field, trying to cut up field, couldn't find any running room. It'll be first and 10 for the Greyhounds on the 30.
McConaughey running left to right from hash mark to hash mark. Unfortunately, didn't get up the field very much. Only picked up about 5 yards on the return. They're going to spot the ball on the 30-yard line as the clock continues to run. 6:42 and counting to go in this ball game. Wilmington down 27-0. First and 10 for the Wilmington Greyhounds on the 30-yard line.
And now Wilmington is going to have to crank up the passing game with any hope of keeping in this ball game. Damon Hart is the quarterback in I formation behind him. Wing back off to the right side of the line. Damon will roll to the right side. Will try for his intended receiver down there. I believe it was Jens Jorgensen down around the 40-yard line. It falls incomplete.
Once again, Hart watching Jorgensen the whole way. Hart rolling out to his left as soon as he took the snap. And Jorgensen running across the field from right to left along with Hart. And Jorgensen just double-teamed on that play. Hart watching him the whole way. By the time he threw the ball, two defenders there. The ball off Jorgensen's fingertips for an incomplete pass. We'll have to watch it. Damon Hart now as he gets this throwing, this passing game going. That time with the deep drop and the rollout to the left, we'll have to see. He was getting in trouble before with his quick one-step drop. We'll have to see what happens now.
Wing T right. The pitch this time is to Smargesso. And Smargesso will get 5 or 6 on the play. Up to the 36-yard line. It's going to be 3rd down and 4. However, the clock is down to 6 minutes now and running, and Wilmington trails 27-0.
Wilmington's going to have to get something going quick, that's for sure. With a 3rd down and 4 now, this is a big first down that they have to pick up. As we said, the Wilmington passing game really going to have to kick into high gear now to get some quick points on the board.
Damon Hart to quarterback. Well, hand off again to Smargesso. Smargesso has the 1st down at the 43. It'll be 1st and 10 for the Greyhounds from there.
Smargesso picks up the 1st down, picks up about 4 more yards to go with it. They're going to spot the ball right on the 44-yard line. Wilmington putting a nice drive together, but with only 5 minutes and 30 seconds to go in the ball game, maybe too little too late for the Wilmington Greyhounds.
Now the Greyhounds up. The clock continues to run with 5:19 remaining in the ball game. Wilmington trails by 4 touchdowns. Damon Hart back to pass. In and out of the hands of the intended receiver, going for it again.
Well, that pass,
Jens Jorgensen.
Pass was underthrown to Jorgensen. Jorgensen, the main target tonight in what limited action the passing game has seen. As we said, only one completion in the entire first half, and that was from Hart to Jorgensen. And hard to recall a completion in the second half.
It's 2nd down and 10 from the Wilmington 44. Damon Hart with the handoff to Smargesso. Down to the 48-yard line. It's going to be short of the 1st down. 3rd down and 3 coming up. 3rd down and 2.
Clock continues to roll with 4:48 to go in this ball game. As for the Greyhounds, Kyle Freeman checks back into the ball game, replacing Sean McConaughey. Wilmington rotating their running backs quite a bit tonight. McConaughey with a big first half, saw a lot of action, and then now Freeman and McConaughey rotating. Smargesso, of course, in there the entire game.
Damon Hart will give it to Samar Gesso. Samar Gesso, good running room. He breaks free to the 25, finally dropped it to 20. Samar Gesso, with some great effort, almost broke free for the touchdown. He's down to the 19-yard line.
Certainly did, and it took Gary Lyons to bring down Samar Gesso, who just broke through a few tackles and was spinning around and looked like he had finally broken into the open field when Lyons cut him down. But still a big game for the Wilmington Greyhounds. They're finally headed in the right direction with 4:11 to go in the fourth quarter. Ball just inside the 20-yard line, spotted at the 19.5, first and 10 for the Wilmington Greyhounds.
Wilmington trailing 27-0. The clock has stopped. 4:11 remains. Now they wind the clock and it'll start. And we'll run under 4 minutes before this play can get off. Heading out to the right side is Jorgensen. Wing T formation, wing on the left. The handoff to Samar Gesso. He tries the right left side. He cuts. He's down to the 14-yard line. Clock continues to run now. It's short of the first down. It's going to be second down and 3.
Another strong run by Samar Gesso, who burst around the left side. It looked like he was going to take it through around the outside, saw it over to the inside, cut back through there. They pick up on the play of 7 yards, second down to 3 for the Wilmington Greyhounds, but unfortunately for the Greyhounds, just 3 minutes and 20 seconds to go in this ball game.
And the handoff again, I think, was to Samar Gesso, down to the 10.
That time Kyle Freeman carries the ball for the Wilmington Greyhounds, and the ball just inside the 10-yard line. And it looks like it's going to be close enough for the first down.
It'll be first and goal from the Greyhounds from the 10. It's their first threat since near the end of the first half. 2:58, clock runs. Shenango leads 27-0. He's Samar Gesso, head to the end zone. Touchdown, he's Samar Gesso.
Samar Gesso, another good strong run. That time he chose the right-hand side and went right through the right-hand side of his line. Found the hole, bounced off a few people, and Samar Gesso, really, when he gets those legs going, it's tough to bring him down. That was the case right there. Kept the legs churning and burst right through for the touchdown. Stayed on his feet and put 6 points on the board for the Wilmington Greyhounds.
Now Adam Clapper will get a chance to try for the extra point. Snap is down, the kick is up. It's going to be wide to the left. So it's no good with now the score 27-6. There's 2:48 remaining in the ball game. We'll return in 30 seconds on your Tri-County stations. Welcome back here to Wilmington Area High School, where Wilmington has put the first points on the board for the Greyhounds with only 2 minutes and 48 seconds remaining in the ball game. Wilmington trails Shenango 27-6. And they will be kicking the ball off to the Wildcats now. Adam Clapper kicks the ball away. And it's being picked up by the return man, Chris Johnson. Johnson to the 23, that's all he'll get. He's tripped up there, 33-yard line is where they'll place the ball. And now Shenango will try to run the clock out. 2:42 remains, the clock has stopped here as they set the chains.
Well, Wilmington, after having trouble defending the Shenango running game, put together a good running drive of their own and managed to put their first points on the scoreboard. 27-6 is the score, and even with those 6 points, that certainly makes the Wilmington team feel a lot better than if they would have been shut out in this ball game. Wilmington's not done yet, that's for sure, and Shenango certainly isn't either, as they're set to put another drive together, starting with the ball on the 33-yard line. 2 minutes and 20 seconds to go in this ball game. Shenango tries to put a few more on the board. Right now they have 27 to Wilmington 6.
A new quarterback into the game for Shenango Wildcats, and breaking through the line for the Wildcats, Mike Christ. It'll be first and 10 for the Wildcats, as that was nearly broken for another touchdown. Up at the Shenango Wildcat 47. A lot of substitutions in now. Now playing quarterback Vincent Hardwinski for the Shenango Wildcats.
Mike Christ in the ballgame as well, as you said, with that big run, and Christ untouched through the hole. Samar Gesso playing defensive halfback for the Greyhounds, cut straight across the field to put the tackle on Christ.
And the handoff again was to Jim Christ.
Mike Crist, that is, into Wilmington Greyhound territory. It's going to be second down and four for the Shenango Wildcats on the Greyhound 47-yard line.
Well, two big gains by Mike Crist, and Shenango is starting to threaten once again. Still a ways from the end zone, but with the ball on the 47-yard line.
The clock is down to 1:16. Shenango's going to win this one. And Wilmington will be have their first loss. And Shenango their first win in Tri-County play. And one of the Wilmington defenders jumped. Now we'll see whether that defender was drawn off.
Well, it was sophomore Ed Gerst who jumped off sides.
I believe this one's...
And it's going to go against Gerst. They're going to mark it off 5 yards against the Greyhound. So that'll give Shenango five more yards. Clock stopped at 1:05 to go. It'll be first down and 10. 42-yard line is where the ball spotted for the Shenango Wildcats.
And the Wildcat fans are celebrating on the far side. The clock down to 55 seconds. Mart Winsky is the quarterback, replacing William DeCarbo. The handoff and cutting down there for a good gain on the play is Jimmy Hernandez as the substitutes are in. And a ball down on the Wilmington Greyhound 36-yard line, second down and three for Shenango. Clock running to 27 seconds.
One more play for the Shenango Wildcats to see what they can do. 41 yards from the end zone, but what really matters is the clock winding down at 17 seconds and counting. Shenango Wildcats going to win this ball game. One more play, we'll see what they do with it.
This should be the final play of the ball game as the clock's at 10. And Mark, the quarterback will keep it himself, Mark Winsky. He'll run towards the sideline. The clock stopped with 2 seconds. And now the clock runs down to zero. That's the end of the ball game. We'll say goodbye to our tape delay TV audience on Channel 9 and Channel 18 Adelphia. Thanks for being along here on the live radio audience. We'll return for a wrap-up of this game in 60 seconds as Shenango wins 27-6 on your Tri-County stations.